He said, I don't want you. Amen. He said, I don't want you just marrying anybody.
That's right.
You are going to work today. I must have said, so look at your neighbor and say, who you go out with? Who you go out with? Because you're in choir. Y'all don't like this kind of talk, but I got to say what God tell you. Ask your neighbor, who you go out with? Because you can't just go out with anybody. You can't drink tea with everybody. You ain't lay down with just anybody. You don't know why you're crazy, because you have that crazy spirit inside of you. Oh, yeah. Why you jerking it, doing a hurricane jerk, because you attached to a jerk. Anybody. He spoke to Israel through Moses and said, don't give your daughters to their son. Said there's a reason for it. God's going to tell you, because it's many of y'all that are coming into this house. And I don't want y'all to make my brother have to work it and be calling your man every five past to call him so he had just come to church. No. When you get up in here, you tell him, I'm saved now. And if you don't want to be saved, then go away. You've been striving too long to be connected with just anybody. You've been coming to church. show you. I can't wait for myself. Y'all know what's wrong with some of us. Some of us, we just know too much.
Right.
And that's why our lives are jacked up. We don't moan in the pastor, moan in the women's director, moan in the, well, you know, you always got a suggestion. You always got an idea. How about we see how it goes first? We're going to debrief.
Right.
Oh, my God. I can't even get into my leg. We want to just do what we want to do. We make up our mind, I handle it, and you get yourself twisted and tied up into something that you don't belong in. You get yourself dragged in a direction, and some of us say, I'm witnessing to them. At the club, for real? I'm influencing me. And go ahead and date them when we have no business dating them. You ain't got to do nothing, Pastor Harry. Just sit there and just look straight. God sent me here for you. Some of us go out and call ourselves saving them. Some of y'all give them the Holy Ghost. Y'all don't got to like my talk. Some of y'all can't wait till they get dry. At the baptism of hope. Can he speak? Sticky, sticky, sticky. There he is. That's it. Look at your neighbor and say, leave him alone. Just leave him alone. thought that he could handle him. And he can change Jezebel. See, you can't change nobody. God has to do the changing. Quit trying to be superwoman. And he thought he could change her, but she changed him. And y'all know the Bible story. When she got there, he found out that she was masquerading. Yeah. You know they real nice until they get you.
Right.
I wish somebody hit me tonight. He thought she was for real, but she wasn't for real. He thought she embraced his God, but she didn't embrace his God. When he married this woman, he found out she brought with her all of her strange God. You wonder why you itching, you wonder why. Y'all better watch that spaghetti, you better watch that stuff, you better watch that cooler. I ain't playing with y'all.
That's right.
People are crazy.
Yes,
people are doing witchcraft.
Yes,
I got warlocks after me. I got people trying to hand me gifts after church. Keep your stuff. The devil is after your anointing. The devil is after your virtue. The devil is after your power. And he don't care how he gets it. She brought Baal into Israel. And when she brought Baal into Israel, the nation fell. Trying to help y'all, new beginners. When she brought the wrong thing into Israel, the nation fell into confusion. They didn't know right from wrong. They didn't know God from a false God. Can I witness that? The Bible says she placed her idols and her idolatrous temples all throughout the land. Everywhere you looked, she turned. Everywhere you turned, there was Baal. And here was side by side. There was Jehovah, then there was Baal. There was Baal, and then there was Jehovah. But here's come forth this prophet by the name of Elijah. Somebody say Elijah. There was something about Elijah. And Elijah just pops up on the scene. And it was his responsibility to reestablish who God was in the nation.
Preaching
to you today. Yeah. You gotta reestablish who he is in the nation. You gotta bring God. You know, we done got into entertainment street, but Jesus is on his way back. And we gotta establish the sovereignty of God in the nation. What I love about Elisha is he emerges seemingly out of nowhere. Amen. If you read the Bible, you'll notice that you never read anything about Elijah until right there in the middle of 1 Kings. You never see his name at any point in time before. It just seems like all of a sudden, out of nowhere, here comes Jayon. As a matter of fact, the Bible identifies him as Elijah the Tishbite. We don't even know what a Tishbite is. The Bible don't give us no description. It doesn't tell us of the identity of a Tishbite. We don't know the background. We don't know the lineage. Or we don't know if he comes from a priestly family. We don't know anything about his daddy or his mama. We don't know if he comes from a prophetical line. And suppose sometimes God plans it that way. He hides biographical lineage. He hides your background. He hides your lineage and family history in order to let us know that the way to get ahead in God is not based on who your mama or your daddy is, but the way to get ahead in God is not who you connected to, but the way to get ahead in him is to be anointed. I wish I was in the right church. Shake somebody's hand and say, are you anointed? I don't care how good you can sing, but are you anointed? Will take you where other stuff can't take you. The anointing will take you where people can't take it. You need it. Our church is in a crisis right now.
Yes.
Oftentimes we've gotten in the wrong direction. We got the wrong mindset. I'm almost there. But